to find out what's in store for our favorite celebrities based on their zodiac signs, right, Cass?
Yes, here to forecast what's in the stars and break down all things astrological is celebrity astrologer, the Leo King, a.k.a. David Palmer, joining us.
Oh, man, we had to have you on, man.
Oh, thank you so much for having me on. I'm super excited.
She reads the stars and the moons. It's all on.
I love it. Retrograde, anything like that, yeah, no. I'm all for it.
And how crazy was 2018, right?
It was really wild.
We're leaving
right?
that in the past. Yes. We are focusing on 2019 and what? What's in store for some of our favorite celebrities, beginning with Justin Bieber. So he is, well, actually, you know what? We should break down first, like, astrology for maybe those who don't.
Like me.
I was just so excited. I wanted to
get into
it.
I know. I do have genuine, like, general questions about, like, you know, what is the zodiac sign and what does it mean? Like, how does it correlate with our birthdays?
Well, I mean, when you were born, of course, all the planets, we take a snapshot of where they all were. And especially when we talk about sun signs, it's the sun's position on what we call the tropical ecliptic zodiac line, which basically there's 12 signs around this whole entire part of Earth that we see where the sun's ecliptic is. And what that is if you notice, the sun's always in the same line every day where it sets and where and where it rises. Right. So it's not like the sun's always over there, but there's a belt of those 12 zodiac signs, and that's where we know where you're born. And those zodiac signs hold lots of traits, and when you add the other planets too, oh my gosh.
So there are sun signs and there's moon signs. Right?
Yes, and those are very dominant because those are the illuminaries, right? Because they're illuminating like actual light, right? So your moon's your emotional self and your sun is more of your core soul expression.
Interesting. Okay. So when people say like, oh, you're an Aquarius or you're a Libra, that is just kind of traits of who you are?
That's more, I mean, they can go all the way to psychological, mechanical, and more of like your spiritual self and how you psychologically and spiritually react to life.
Interesting.
So like you mentioned, 2018 was major for these celebs we're going to get into. We want to help predict what's in store for them in 2019.
Beginning with Mr. Justin Bieber, who is a Pisces. His birthday is March 1st, 1994. Now, how much of that information do you need to take in, you know, for when you figure out 2019 for what's in store for
him? Well, I look at his chart and I look at his positions of his planets, of course, when he was born, because the planets are moving every second. So everybody's got a unique chart, right? And he's got a very big year ahead of him.
Does he?
Yeah.
I mean, he just got married.
He just got married. And I think for him, career-wise, is going to be big. He's going to be doing stuff he's never done before. We're going to see him doing stuff besides just music and like little cameos or appearances. I really see him changing into doing more stuff, whether that's more TV, more media aspects, being more out there. And I think for him, this relationship is having him shift, especially when it comes to having more of a foundation. I think he's been a little all over the place, which has been, he's really fluid because that's how Pisces are.
Right.
But this is a huge year for Pisces with career, huge year for them. And relationships are getting much easier. 2020, though, he'll be reevaluating how this relationship and the new career stuff is all going to be working.
And how he's going to balance it out a little bit. Because I will say, this past year, he was really focused on this love life. I mean, it was like secret marriage, you know? And then I think he was like really cultivating that. But you're saying we're going to get more Bieber on our screen.
Yeah, especially way out there more.
Definitely. Love it. All right, let's get into our girl Taylor Swift. She is a Sagittarius. She was born on December 13th, 1989. Of course, who could forget that? Right. This has been a huge year for her career, though. She just wrapped up the Reputation Stadium Tour. She signed a contract with a new music company. So how does that reflect in the stars for 2019?
Well, it's a big year for Sagittariuses because Jupiter just entered Sagittarius literally a couple weeks ago, and it's there all the way through till December 2nd of 2019.
Oh, wow.
So for having... That's a big deal because Sagittarius is their planet is Jupiter. So when it comes to home, it's like huge for them.
Wow.
Now for her, it's going to be still continuing great career stuff, but for her, it's her values are changing a lot. So that also combines the relationship aspect.
Okay, that's what we really want to
see. Right.
She has a weird Venus. Venus is the planet of love and beauty and relationships. And she's having a very hard transit that started last year. So for her, it's like there's not a lot of stability with relationships. Mm-hmm. There's going to be, though, the second part of 2019. But there's going to be some unpredictable sparks for the first 6 months of 2019.
Really?
So right when you think you know it's going to be what it is with her in a relationship, it's not. It's going to just whoop, 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 whoop.
Because that's interesting. Because she's been dating her boyfriend, Joe Alwyn, for a minute now.
Yeah.
Like, so in 2019, you're not thinking wedding bells then for them.
I would think I would think that for her, I'm not saying that it's going to be horrible. It's just that there's going to be so many unpredictable things that are happening in the relationship. And more importantly for her, she's reassessing the values of where she's going now, who she wants to be, because just kind of like Justin Bieber, there's a part of her also wanting to expand in her life. And does the relationship work with that? So it's more of her reassessing, you know, what she really wants out there. And I think she's not easy to please, to be honest with you. Just because she's got a lot that she wants. She wants... And she needs stimulation.
Right.
She's very heavily with the stimulation. That's why her music, she puts so much
Taylor
in.
Swift.
But I think that there's a part of her now that's like, where else is that?
Okay. You know? She's always hungry for
I
more.
Am fascinated.
Me
this.
Too.
I want to say one more thing real quick is that she is going through what we call the Saturn return, which happens every 30 years. She's coming to, you know, coming into this big rite of passage, and she's trying to almost kind of settle down, but there's a dreamer part of her she can't get rid of. And so that's her big choice.
Okay.
Is she going to box herself, or is she going to continue to be the wild and crazy?
She's not one. Yeah,
she's not one to box herself in.
Jeez. Wow, we're really synced up.
You'd think we were the same size.
I know, right? I can't wait to see what's in store for her. And also Beyonce. Beyonce's a Virgo, born September 4th, 1981. I didn't even have to look down at my card for that. I knew that. She went on a huge tour with her husband this past year, Jay-Z. What's next for B next year? I mean, is she going, any plans to expand the family, maybe drop a new album? What do you have in the stars for B?
Wow. You know, with Beyonce, I got to say, there is the biggest changes of all the celebrities I've seen coming to her.
What?
Wow.
Definitely relationship-wise. So there's been a lot of relationship stuff with her and Jay-Z, and Jay-Z is a Sagittarius. So he's got this Jupiter aspect with him. She's a Virgo. So, you know, Jay-Z's very big and with all of his energy, and you'd think Beyonce is too. She's got a beautiful voice, everything, but she's much more, you know, specific about things, much more like in a rhythm, and we know what she's doing, but her Venus, which was relationship, is getting the hardest hit that it's ever going to have. And this goes back to stuff that's been going for 5 years or more.
So I'm shook.
I think that all the stuff that's been going on with her relationship wise is coming up to the full real catapult situation of like, is this really going to be together or not? Like, I think it's been Band-Aid,
it's gonna
Band-Aid,
be like
Band-Aid,
a,
Band-Aid, Band-Aid. But this is like, there's no more Band-Aids allowed, you know, surgery or amputation.
Okay, so they're being put to the test.
The decision will be made, it sounds like.
I think that, you know, there's a lot to assess. So, but, you know, at the end of the day, I think it's either going to go really good for them either way, because they'll have figured out if they're staying and got rid of all that stuff or not.
Prayers for the Carters. Okay.
another duo that may need some prayers. Yeah. Cardi B. So she's a Libra. Her birthday's October 11, 1992. Obviously, having split from her baby's father, Offset this past month. You know, there's a lot going on between those two. What about like a resolution in her love life? Like, is that in the stars for her?
She's had a lot of like, she's number one, she's born on a full moon too. She's a Libra and born on a full moon with, you know, the imbalance can become emotionally intense.
Yeah.
And she's had Pluto actually been making really intense aspects all over her chart. So it's almost felt like it's like been, you know, just the tower falling and then being rebuilt and then falling. But this year there's more stability, but it's not going to be for her, I think, like, she's a very extreme, intense personality, and things are going to kind of slow down to kind of stabilize what has been done. So if she does get back with love, which is a really great possibility, especially for Libras this year, it's going to need to be more like, you know, slower.
Okay.
Like, it's going to need to take some time.
Now, question for you, David. Does this apply for all Libras?
Well, for Libras, her specifically, it's a little bit more intense. But for all Libras, they're actually coming into a great space. They're ready to find a new rhythm, better relationships that aren't so crazy.
Crazy relationship time.
I'm a Libra, so thank you. Phew.
Yes.
2019, I'm ready for you. Okay, we got to move on. Kylie Jenner, thank you.
Yeah.
Leo, August 10, 1997 is when she was born. She's going to be on tour, actually, with her husband, Travis Scott, or excuse me, rumored husband, Travis Scott. Mm-hmm. Do you see wedding bells in their future?
Or the past?
Or the past. Or has it already happened? What's her love life looking like?
Well, for her, it's a huge year for Leo's for love.
Okay.
This is, like, very big. But is the reality, like, her work life and... That's a big deal. Is her work life and her schedule really going to work with him? That's what she has to pay attention to. And is that, where's her true happiness? So love is more than just a relationship, right? It's the love of her career and making sure she has a partner. I think for her, it's going to take, actually it's going to happen rather fast. I think you're going to see here in January and February for her really starting to make decisions like that really quick. But I think it's all depending on if she really feels really happy with that and the work, and maybe some of this tour stuff and all that. Right. That'll unveil what it is. Yeah. But it's a great year, and she was born on the exact day of where we just had basically an eclipse in 2018 here. So that means it's more intense for her. So she has big, intense decisions in her life and huge, huge career stuff. If you thought her career stuff was already big,
that's
just like the surface. That's nothing.
Collect your coin, Kylie Jenner. Oh, man, I love it.
No, she's going to be huge. And this is a big year for her. Really big. But for love, she has to be really happy.
Real quick, could next year be the year that she has another kid? Could Stormy be gaining a sibling?
I think for her, she has to determine if her schedule can handle that, right? Mm-hmm. Unless she's Angelina Jolie, right? I mean, she shows that she can handle it.
She might happen.
But, you know, I think for Leos, they can get really stressed, right?
Totally.
And so for her, it's managing stress this year. And can Travis continue to be the guy who handles the stress for her and be there? Or can he even handle that? That's a lot to think.
Amazing stuff.
Wow.
Leo King David Palmer. Yeah. That's amazing. We're going to sit on all that. And also, we'll come back to this if any of this happens, you know?
Cool.
You guys, you can track your star signs and get your predictions for 2019 direct from David via Twitter at The Leo Kingdom. Thank you for being on the show.
Thank you so much.
We appreciate it.
All right, guys, coming up, could some artists we haven't